The Fir-Tree by Hans Christian Andersen, narrated by Trevor O'Hare. Far down in the forest, where the warm sun and the fresh air made a sweet resting place, grew a pretty little fir-tree, and yet it was not happy. It wished so much to be tall like its companions, the pines and firs which grew around it. The sun shone, and the soft air fluttered its leaves, and the little peasant children passed by, prattling merrily, but the fir-tree heeded them not. Sometimes the children would bring a large basket of raspberries or strawberries, wreathed on a straw, and seat themselves near the fir-tree, and say, "Is it not a pretty little tree?" which made it feel more unhappy than before. And yet all this while the tree grew a notch or joint taller every year, for by the number of joints in the stem of a fir-tree, we can discover its age. Still, as it grew, it complained. "Oh, how I wish I were as tall as the other trees. Then I would spread out my branches on every side, and my top would overlook the wide world. I should have the birds building their nests on my boughs, and when the wind blew, I should bow with stately dignity like my tall companions." The tree was so discontented that it took no pleasure in the warm sunshine, the birds, or the rosy clouds that floated over it morning and evening. Sometimes in winter, when the snow lay white and glittering on the ground, a hare would come springing along and jump right over the little tree, and then how mortified it would feel. 2 winters passed, and when the third arrived, the tree had grown so tall that the hare was obliged to run round it. Yet it remained unsatisfied and would exclaim, "Oh, if I could but keep on growing tall and old. There's nothing else worth caring for in the world." In the autumn, as usual, the woodcutters came and cut down several of the tallest trees, and the young fir tree, which was now grown to its full height, shuddered as the noble trees fell to the earth with a crash. After the branches were lopped off, the trunks looked so slender and bare that they could scarcely be recognized. Then they were placed upon wagons and drawn by horses out of the forest. Where were they going? What would become of them? The young fir tree wished very much to know, so in the spring when the swallows and the storks came, it asked, "Do you know where those trees were taken? Did you meet them?" The swallows knew nothing, but the stork, after a little reflection, nodded his head and said, "Yes, I think I do. I met several new ships when I flew from Egypt, and they had fine masts that smelt like fir. I think these must have been the trees. I assure you, they were stately, very stately." "Oh, how I wish I were tall enough to go on the sea," said the fir tree. "What is the sea, and what does it look like?" "It would take too much time to explain," said the stork, flying quickly away. "Rejoice in thy youth," said the sunbeam. "Rejoice in thy fresh growth and the young life that is in thee." And the wind kissed the tree, and the dew watered it with tears, but the fir tree regarded them not. Christmas time drew near, and many young trees were cut down, some even smaller and younger than the fir tree, who enjoyed neither rest nor peace with longing to leave its forest home. These young trees, which were chosen for their beauty, kept their branches and were also laid on wagons and drawn by horses out of the forest. "Where are they going?" asked the fir tree. "They are not taller than I am. Indeed, one is much less. And why are the branches not cut off? Where are they going?" we know," sang the sparrows. "We looked in at the windows of the houses in the town, and we know what is done with them. They are dressed up in the most splendid manner. We have seen them standing in the middle of a warm room and adorned with all sorts of beautiful things, honey cakes, gilded apples, playthings, and many hundreds of wax tapers." "And then," asked the fir tree, trembling through all its branches, "and then what happens?" "We did not see any more," said the sparrows, "but this was enough for us." "I wonder whether anything so brilliant will ever happen to me," thought the fir tree. "It would be much better than crossing the sea. I long for it almost with pain. Oh, when will Christmas be here? I am now as tall and well-grown as those which were taken away last year. Oh, that I were now laid on the wagon or standing in the warm room, with all the brightness and splendor around me. Something better and more beautiful is to come after, or the trees would not be so decked out. Yes, what follows will be grander and more splendid. What can it be? I am weary with longing. I scarcely know how I feel." "Rejoice with us," said the air and the sunlight. "Enjoy thine own bright life in the fresh air." But the tree would not rejoice, though it grew taller every day. In winter and summer, its dark green foliage might be seen in the forest, while passers-by would say, "What a beautiful tree!" A short time before Christmas, the discontented fir tree was the first to fall. As the axe cut through the stem and divided the pith, The tree fell with a groan to the earth, conscious of pain and faintness, and forgetting all its anticipation of happiness, in sorrow at leaving its home in the forest. It knew that it should never again see it.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.